waves, and up through Oxford he pursued his evil aims, rejoicing in his title of the Terror of the Thames.
His manner and appearance did not calculate to please. His coat was torn and seedy, it was baggy at the knees.
One ear was somewhat missing, no need to tell you why. And he scowled upon a hostile world from one forbidding eye.
The cottagers of Rotherhithe knew something of his fame. At Hammersmith and Putney people shuddered at his name. They would fortify the hen house, lock up the silly goose.
When the rumor ran along the shore,
all tigers on the loose.
Woe to the weak canary that fluttered from its cage.
Woe to the pampered Pekingese that faced Growl Tiger's rage.
Woe to the bristling bandicoot that lurks on foreign ships.
And woe to any cat with whom Growl Tiger came to grips.
But most to cats of foreign race his hatred had been vowed. To cats of foreign name and race no quarter was allowed. The Persian and the Siamese regarded him with fear, because it was a Siamese that all his missing year.
Now on a peaceful summer night, all nature seemed at play. The tender moon was shining bright, the barge at Molesey lay. All in the balmy moonlight it lay rocking on the tide, and Growl Tiger was disposed to show his sentimental side.
Chielo
mi amore, and my rapish crew were sleeping in their barrels and their bunks.
As the Siamese came creeping in their sandpans and their junks,
Growl Tiger had no eye or ear for aught but Griddlebone.
And the lady seemed enraptured by my manly baritone,
disposed to relaxation and awaiting notice.